Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be discussing about the second problem of today's biweekly contest, minimum array length after pair removals. The problem is a bit tricky and you can see it from the submissions itself. As always, I will try to walk you through the thought process that I had while solving this problem during the contest. So with that, let's get started. The problem states that you are given a zero indexed array nums, sorted array nums, and you can perform the following operation any number of times. The operation is, you will choose two indexes I and j such that I is less than j and nums of I is less than nums of j. And then you will remove the two indexes I and j from the given array nums, and the remaining elements will retain their order and the array is reindexed. So notice that the remaining element will also be in the sorted order after I and j are removed. Now you have to return an integer denoting the minimum length of nums after performing the operation n number of times, right? So let's take an example. Let's say nums is 1, 3, 4, 9. So in this case, you can select I equals to 0 and j equals to 1 initially, and you can remove 0 and 1 because nums of I, which is 1, is less than nums of j, which is 3, right? After you remove 1 and 3, you will be left with 4 and 9. Now again, you can apply the exact same operation. You can say nums of I, which is 4, is less than nums of j, which is 9, and hence you can remove this 4 and 9 as well. So finally, you will be left with empty array, which is the minimum length possible for the nums, right? And hence the answer here is 0. Basically, after performing some operations, you are able to reduce the given array into an empty array, and hence the answer here is 0. Let's take one last example. Let's say nums is 1, 1, 2. So in this case, you can say, okay, nums of 0, I is 0 and j is 1, j is 2, and you can say nums of 0, which is 1, is less than nums of 2, which is 2, and because nums of i is less than nums of j, you can actually remove I and j, and the remaining array would just contain a single integer 1. And you can't actually pair this integer with any other integer, and hence the length, final length that you can achieve is just 1, right? So hope you understand the problem statement. Now how to solve this? One of the most important thing in this problem was that the given index, given array, is actually a sorted array. So let's see how we can utilize that. Let's say nums is sorted. It inherently means that nums of I is less than equals to nums of j, right? For all I and j. Now we have to figure out, or we can remove I and j only when I is less than j and nums of I is less than nums of j. That's what this condition denotes, right? Now notice, if nums contain only unique elements, there are no duplicates in the given array nums, so in that case you can easily say that nums of I is less than nums of j, right? It doesn't matter what nums of I and nums of j are, because they are unique, it means equal to condition is not satisfied, and hence nums of I is always less than nums of j. In other words, this condition will always be satisfied no matter what I and j are. So you might say that, okay, I should be less than j, but that's fine. Like, let's say you pick this as I and this as j, that's fine. You can just swap I and j. You can say, okay, instead of this as I and this of j, I will just pick these two elements itself, but I will just swap these two. This will be I and this will be j, right? And I already know that for all I and j, such that I less than j, nums of I is already less than nums of j. All of these is true only when the given array contains unique elements, no duplicates, right? So if there are no duplicates, what is the answer? The answer is 1 if the array length is even, if the array length is odd, and answer is 0 if the array length is even, right? So just to reiterate, let's say this is the given array of length 10, and we are saying that all the elements are unique. So because all the elements are unique, one simple strategy could be pick adjacent element every time and remove it. This is ICJ, I will remove these two because I am sure that these two are not equal, and as the array is sorted, nums of I will be less than nums of j, and hence I can actually remove these two elements. Similarly, after this I will pick this is I and this is j, and I will remove these two, and I will keep on doing this until I reach the end. And because the array length is even, everything in the array will be destroyed at the end, and the remaining array length would be zero at the end. And hence, if the array length is even, the number of element that I will be left with will be zero. If the array length is odd, the number of elements I will be left with is one, right? So hope you understand the solution if the given array doesn't contain any duplicates. But the given problem doesn't state that. Given in the given problem, we can have duplicates. It means we can have less than equal to condition satisfied, right? And we have to only care about those, and we only care about those pairs where it is strictly less than, not equal, right? So in other words, the problem is now reduced to counting the number of pairs such that nums of I is not equals to nums of j, and as always I will be less than j. We'll take care of that. So this is our new problem. We have to just count the number of pairs such that they are not equal, the values are not equal. Now pairing can be done in various different ways, right? What one way that we just saw before is you can say, okay, this will be I and this will be j, adjacent pairs will be I and j, and based on whether they are equal or not, I will remove them or I will keep them, right? If they are equal, I have to keep them. If they are not equal, I will remove them, right? So this is one possible way to pair. Another possible way could be this: I will pair up the first element with the last element, second element with the second last element, and so on and so forth. Now if this is this and this are equal, it means I will not remove these two elements, and these two elements will stay in the final array as well. And in the same fashion, if this and this are equal, I will not remove it and I will keep it, otherwise I will remove it. So another possible pairing could be pair up this with the first element after the midpoint, second element with the second element after the midpoint, third element with the third element after the midpoint, and so on and so forth. So which of this pairing strategy will give us the correct result, or will give us the best result, right? We want to select as many pairs as possible, right? So let's just take an example to make this a bit more clear. So let's say this is the given array, and we have applied all the three strategies. Note that there are other strategies as well. For example, you can pair up this with this, pair up this with this, and then say, okay, pair up this with this, pair up this with this, and so on and so forth. But we will see how those strategies will also not be applicable, or will also not give us the optimal result in certain scenarios. So for now, we will work with these three scenarios only. Let's say this is the array and we are pairing up. So this is one possible way to pair, right? We saw that. Now notice that these two elements were different, so we just say that, okay, this and this will be removed from the given array. Now these two were not equal, so either you can keep both of them or just keep one of them and see if you can pair up this with the next one, right? Because you want maximum number to be removed from the given array, right? So that's where we will keep this and instead pair up this with the one which is not equal, and so on and so forth. Now you can see in this particular scenario we are able to remove 8 elements. 2 elements actually remained, right? Now if I pair up in this strategy, in this particular scenario we are able to remove all the 10 elements. How? You can see we paired up 1 with 4, and 1 and 4 are not equal, so 1 and 4 will be removed, right? Similarly, we paired up 2 with 5, again they are not equal, so they will be removed. We paired up 2 with 6, and so on and so forth. Basically, we will be able to remove all the 10 elements in this particular pairing order. And similarly, in this particular order as well, we are also able to remove all the 10 elements. So basically, this pairing strategy clearly is not the optimal pairing strategy, and these two may be the optimal strategy. We don't know for sure yet, but these two may be the optimal strategy, this strategy for sure will not work, right? Now, let's try to understand why this strategy failed for the first place. So, this strategy failed only because of duplicates element in the adjacent places. So, because the array is sorted, it is certain that duplicate elements will be present in succession, right? So you know that 2 and 2 will be there adjacent to each other. Similarly, this 2 and this 2 will be there when adjacent to each other. So basically, any pair which or any pair which are equal, they will be adjacent. And because we can't take equal pairs to remove the pair, we will be getting some pairs which we can't actually remove, and hence this strategy might not give us the best result. So in this particular case itself, you can see you could have paired this 2 with this 8, and that can give you all the 10 numbers removed. So the reason why this strategy didn't work is we wanted to take care of all the non-equal pairs, but because we are pairing up adjacent elements and adjacent elements are the ones which have equal elements, this might give us some pairs which we might not be able to form at all, right? Now in the similar fashion, if you apply the same thought process here, you can see you are pairing up this one with the farthest with some farther element. So in this case, the probability of these two getting equal is much lower than the probability of these two getting equal in above scenario, right? And hence this strategy is definitely better than this. Let's talk about this one as well. In this case, we paired up this one with 8, paired up with 2 with 7, this 2 with 6, and so on and so forth. So basically, again we are pairing up this 1 with the farthest possible element, this 2 with the farthest possible 7, and so on and so forth. So this strategy is again better than this one. But if you might have noticed that there is a point where we will be dealing with adjacent element in this strategy itself, right? So because of same argument, let's say in this case they are not equal, but it might happen that they are equal, right? So in that case, what will you do? This pairing will not work. This pairing will not give you all the 10 elements, but this might give you all the 10 elements, right? Because again, there is no adjacent element at least in this particular ordering. So probability of getting equal pairs in this order is also greater than the probability in the previous order. So this order can be or may be the best order possible. Now let's just take one example to generalize this particular statement. So let's say the given array is this. Now in this case, you can see clearly that if you apply, first of all, let's forget about this strategy at all, because we already proved that this is not an optimal strategy. You will be able to get as good answer with these two strategies as well. Now for this strategy, you can see in this case you will be pairing up this one with this 3, this one with this 2, and so on and so forth. Now after 2 pairs, you will not be able to pair up anything because everything here is 2. Now because in this strategy as well, we are talking about this one, so in this strategy as well, we are coming closer to equal elements after every iteration, and hence the probability of getting them equal is increasing here. Whereas in this particular situation, we can see this will be mapped with this, and finally this will be mapped with this. So in this case, we can see we get these 3, right? In the previous iteration, we get only 2 pair different, but in this case, we get 3 pair. Now, think logically. Why this can be the best choice? The reason being, you pair up this 3 with this 1, right? Now this is the best possible thing you can do. Let's say they are equal. Let's say this is 2 and this is also 2. It in turns mean that these all are 2, right? Because they are sorted. So if in this entire region is 2, then only this pair will not be possible, right? And if this pair is not possible, no matter which element you pick to pair up with this, it valid pair, right? So in other words, this number cannot be paired with anything afterwards, and hence we can say that this number will be left alone after everything is done, right? So in this case, you might think that okay, why not I will pair this with something before. That is the answer is, if you have, let's say you are able to pair up this one with something before. So let's just get rid of some of these stuff. So let's say you are able to pair up this 2 with some of the element before. This arrangement is as good as pairing up this one with some of the element in this range, right? Because you know all of them are 2. So if these two can be paired up with this one, this one will surely be paired up with one of the 2s that this one will. So you can see, whatever we are able to do with pair of this with previous element, we will be able to do the same by pairing this with the strategy of one with the first middle element, second element with the second middle element, and so on and so forth. So that's where this strategy of pairing will actually give us the best possible, or best will have the highest probability of giving non-equal elements or non-equal pairings. All other possibility, you will see that there will be a point where you are getting too close, and there the chances of getting them equal will start increasing. So hope this intuition makes sense. Now the strategy is simple. Just figure out the middle element. Once you figure out the middle element, just start pairing the first one with the first middle element, second one in the second one in the middle element, and so on and so forth. And based on which of them are equal, you will either not remove that element or you will remove that element, right? Now let's just talk about the scenario where the given array is odd. So this scenario is no different than the even scenario. It's just that we need to decide whether I should, what is the middle element. Basically, should I pair up this one with this two, or should I pair up this one with this two? Now I would encourage you to pause and try to think about this yourself, because we have discussed this already in the previous section. So the answer is, this choice will surely be better than this one. Why? Because the probability of this and this getting not equal is much larger than the probability of getting this and this equal, right? And hence in case of odd elements, we will just ignore the middle element completely and start pairing up the element as we were doing previously, right? So we will do something like this. Now in this particular scenario, we can see this 2 and this 3 are not equal, so we can remove these 2 elements, right? Similarly, this 2 and this 2 are equal, so we can't remove this 2 element. This 1 and this 2 are not equal, we can remove it. This 1 and this 2 is not equal, we can remove it. And the middle element will stay as it is. So in total, we are able to remove 6 elements. We are able to remove 6 elements. We had 9 elements, so we are remained with 3 elements, and that will be the result for this particular scenario. So hope this interpretation makes sense. Next, we're looking at the code. The code is very straightforward. What we have done is exactly what we just discussed. We found the middle element, and notice that we have done n by 2 just because this will give us the middle element. In case of odd numbers, this will give us the index of this particular element itself. Now, as discussed, we will be mapping this with the last one, this with the second last, this with the third last, and so on and so forth. So we just took two pointers L and R. L is mu minus 1, R is the last element. We are trying to map L with R, and we have said that if nums of L is equal to nums of R, we will simply decrement L. Now if that not the case, we will decrement both L and R, and also add plus 2 to the removed number of element that we have removed. Now notice that you can actually do this R minus minus as well, and this should pass because as discussed, if not able to pair up some element here, it will not make any sense to pair up with previous element anyways, right? So hope this entire lesson makes sense. If you have any doubts in this particular problem, feel free to post them in the comment section below. I would be able to answer. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and do subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.